is the trainee period essential? Again, for the probationer, as I said, it is not essential. It is for you to take a decision, right? But if you are taking a person as a trainee, again, check with your standing orders. But if you do not have your own certified standing orders, then the model standing orders, is there any period mentioned there? If it is mentioned, then that is the maximum period. Over and above that, see, that should be reasonable. That is the reason many of the cases, particularly with respect to labor and employment, it should be just, it should be fair, right? Equity, justice, and fairness, it must be there, right? So I cannot have a person as a trainee for 6 years. It is not possible. So it is not reasonable, right? Then what are all the positions for which I have to take a person? Suppose, assuming that I'm recruiting a driver. A driver is a skilled workman, skilled person, right? Driving is a skill because it is authorized, license is given by some appropriate authority. Here in this case, the RTO, right? Regional Transport Officers. Then why do you want to give subsequently training to drivers? Then suppose, because already he is a skilled person, right? So part of management, if we want to put those persons consider those persons also as trainees, then we must have clear justification, right? Why in our company we keep the drivers, when we take a person as drivers, even though they are skilled, why do we put them on training? So what kind of training is given? So when you take a person driver as a trainee, then I must be in the position, I should have a clear document why I am taking this person as a trainee, right? Maybe to assess his again attitude or any other thing, right? So they must be knowing about something, a little bit about first aid and all, right? Just for example, I'm saying, so we may have to assess those things. So it is, you can do that, right? But these questions will arise. So it should be reasonable. Similarly, when you put a person on probation, right? And thirdly, the length of either the training period or the probation period. It all should be reasonable, right? If you go on, since there is no specific prohibition, if we keep on having a person as a trainee for say 6 years or 7 years, or if we keep on having a person as a probationer for 8 years, 10 years, I think law will not accept that because it is not at all reasonable. Yeah, I'll move on. So can we mention the address of the principal employer in the order issued to the contract workers? I think again, this is a question I received last time I couldn't address. Yes, for the contract workers, the contractor is the employer. He will be issuing the appointment orders. Definitely, he can mention the address of the principal. Not an issue, right? That will not in any way bring in the employer-employee relationship between the principal employer and the contract worker. But again, when we do that, it should be very, very carefully drafted. That is the thing. Maybe when you draft the appointment order for the contract workers, you get a legal opinion with your consultants, whoever is your advocate, right? So clearly get it drafted, right? But it can be done. You can mention, because the place of work can be the principal employer's establishment, right? But simply because you are mentioning that, it is, I think the liability will not go to the principal employer to consider those people also as employees on a later point of time, right? It will not be there. It will not be so.